There are two powers that alone can effect in their conjunction the great and difficult thing which is the aim of our endeavor, a fixed and unfailing aspiration that calls from below, and a supreme grace from above that answers. But the supreme grace will act only in the conditions of the light and the truth. It will not act in conditions laid upon it by the falsehood and the ignorance. For if it were to yield to the demands of the falsehood, it would defeat its own purpose. These are the conditions of the light and truth, the soul conditions under which the highest force will descend. And it is only the very highest supramental force descending from above and opening from below that can victoriously handle the physical nature and annihilate its difficulties. There must be a total and sincere surrender. There must be an exclusive self-opening to the divine power. There must be a constant and integral choice of the truth that is descending, a constant and integral rejection of the falsehood of the mental, vital, and physical powers and appearances that still rule the earth nature. The surrender must be total and seize all the parts of the being. It is not enough that the psychic should respond and the higher mental accept, or even the inner vital submit, and the inner physical consciousness feel the influence. There must be in no part of the being, even the most external, anything that makes a reserve, anything that hides behind doubts, confusion, and subterfuges, anything that revolts or refuses. If part of the being surrenders, but another part reserves itself, follows its own way, or makes its own conditions, then each time that happens, you are yourself pushing the divine grace away from you. If behind your devotion and surrender you make a cover for your desires, egoistic demands, and vital insistences, if you put these things in place of the true aspiration, or mix them with it, and try to impose them on the divine Shakti, then it is idle to invoke the divine grace to transform you.